So there's two true answers here. And I know this was a rather challenging question, but just imagine how challenging it must have been for Cook and Levin when they figured this out for the first time. So first of all, each snapshot has size polynomial in n. That is true. So why is that? Well, first of all, we said the size of the input is a polynomial of n, or oftentimes it is n, but sometimes it can also be a polynomial. So for example, when we are given a graph with n vertices, then there can be up to n squared edges. But in any case, the input is some polynomial of n. Now, the size of the algorithm or program here, that is constant because the algorithm doesn't change with the input. So we can assume that this here has constant size, no matter what kind of input we are given. And then finally, this is an interesting one. How much memory does our algorithm need? Well, it's an algorithm for a problem in NP, which means it takes only a polynomial number of time steps. And in each time step, it can only modify a constant amount of variables. So the total memory that it needs is some constant times the number of time steps. And since the number of time steps is a polynomial of n, the total space required here for the memory is also a polynomial of n. So you have a polynomial of n plus some constant plus a polynomial of n. So each single snapshot has size polynomial in n. Now the second one, I think that was the easiest one to find out, is of course not true, because we said we're looking at a problem in NP. We've even written it down here on the left side. So we said the number of time steps must be some polynomial, because otherwise the problem wouldn't be in NP. And since we're running on a non-deterministic RAM, we can assume that the number of time steps here is bounded by some polynomial. So since there's only a polynomial number of time steps, there can also only be a polynomial number of snapshots. So there cannot be an exponential number of snapshots. But this, if you take it together, is, well, I don't know if it's pretty cool, but at least it's very useful for the proof that we're trying to do. Because if each snapshot has a size that's polynomial in n, and the total number of snapshots that we have is a polynomial, then you have a situation where you have a polynomial number of polynomial size snapshots, which means that the size of it all taken together is a polynomial times a polynomial, which again is a polynomial. So basically, a complete protocol of what this algorithm here is doing, given this input and using this memory here, the complete protocol only takes up a polynomial amount of space, polynomial in n, the size of the input. What I will now show you is how you can encode a single snapshot. So, for example, this one here or this one here, as a Boolean formula.